I remember growing up in North Vancouver, and we'd be could be down by the beach there and look over, and you could see the Woodward's W glowing up on top of the roof, and everybody knew that was downtown. This is our original pattern that we had for the Woodward's W, and what I have to do is trace it with carbon paper onto our what we call a non-asbestos, just marking out where the electrodes would go. And then this tells us, gives us a pattern of the glass so we can follow it to, when we're heating it and bending it. Right now I'm marking the area that I need to bend. And then I have to take this into the fire, put my blow hose in my mouth so that I can keep the glass inflated. Now I just have to heat it back and forth between the marks that I've made on the glass to give me the desired bend that I want. And then you just kind of shape it a little, pull it out, and give a little blow. And then we take it over to the pattern. Because it's been laying on the pattern, it adds stress to the glass. So we just take it over to our annealing flame and just anneal it to take any of the stress off. All the window displays, they were magnificent, those were. And Santa Claus always up in Toyland. The original was neon outline, and there were bulbs in between which all lit up. I believe the tower was flashing, that it would go in steps, you know, start at the bottom and it would flash up to the W. We fill the tube with neon. We then run current through, which goes through the electrodes, which then reacts with the gas inside, which then lights it up. Then we block out the areas that aren't necessary, you don't want to see them, and then the fellows take them and install them. So it's quite amazing. Someday I'll be able to say to my grandchildren, oh look, Grandma did that.